and welcome. Of all the early work done by Alan Moore, excluding his work for regional magazines and newspapers, the pages he did for BJ and the Bear may be the most obscure. BJ and the Bear was a TV series that ran for 2 years between 1979 and 1981. Basically, it was the misadventures of a freelance trucker, Billy Joe, and his chimpanzee companion, Bear. The series was a cheap blend of movies such as Smokey and the Bandit and the cult classic Clint Eastwood movie, Every Which Way But Loose, all of which was inspired by the CB radio trend that was prevalent at the time. The popularity of the song Convoy by C.W. McCall also helped boost this hobby, its lingo, and trucking in general into popular culture. Personally, I was looking forward to reading an Alan Moore trucker story co-starring a chimpanzee. Sadly, that was not meant to be. The pages Moore produced contain neither the stars of the series nor the iconic truck. Basically, it's filler material. The BJ and the Bear Annual, which was likely published in late 1982 by GrandDreams, contains 6 pages of Alan Moore content. The illustrations are definitely Moore, as they reflect the underground style he used, but it's uncertain whether he provided the writing too. The extraordinary works of Alan Moore only credit him with providing the artwork. Other online sources credit Moore with both writing and artwork. However, that may be a presumption based on the fact that he ordinarily did both, but sometimes he didn't. The pages that are available don't include credits, so it's difficult to definitively state one way or the other. That being said, the 3-page article, Bear's Monkey Business, contains 3 bizarre instances involving monkeys. So, tonally, it does seem like something Moore might write, all things considered. The article is written very simply because, presumably, the target audience was youngsters. The first story is about a truck driver who has his liquor stolen by apes at a specific point in a South African national park. The second story involves a war in Somalia between villagers and an army of monkeys. The third story is about mischievous chimpanzees in Tarzana, the town that emerged around Edgar Rice Burroughs' ranch after World War II. For the record, I did try to discover if these were actual incidents in history, or whether they were fabricated for this feature, or if they were urban legends, or whatever. I couldn't find any indication these events actually happened, but they may be obscure happenings that are difficult to confirm. Regardless, they don't read as being unrealistic, but I couldn't confirm their validity. The remaining 3 pages are illustrations that go along with CB radio slang. And that's it. That's all the pages he produced. Overall, these 6 pages are charming. They're not exactly interesting, beyond being an odd addition to the Alan Moore bibliography. Otherwise, they are what they are, which was likely a paycheck and nothing more. And, well, it's hard to be critical of anyone doing what they need to do in order to pay the rent. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe. If you would like to go a step further, click Join and select the option most suitable for you. Any and all support is greatly appreciated. Thank you. That's it for today. Like, share, subscribe, and comment, and I will talk at you later. Until next time.